On Nationwide this evening, 60 years of the youth organisation Foróige. Our future, all in the hands of these young entrepreneurs. A schoolgirl in Donegal who's employing her mam and dad. Big brother and big sister watching you, the importance of a mentor. And a new business using old-fashioned crafts. You're welcome to the programme, and this evening on Nationwide we are in celebratory mood because Foróige, one of the country's leading youth organisations, is celebrating a very significant birthday. Now, one of Foróige's programmes is Network for Teaching Entrepreneurship, or NIFTE, and here at the Helix today, the NIFTE graduation and award ceremony is taking place. Beautifully displayed here, just a sample of some of the hundreds of projects that were developed throughout the year. And we're going to take a look now at some of the businesses of the future. Ta-da! Calendar girls! Yes, and let's have a look. What does it say? Wow, that is amazing. I think I could like this. What about that? Yeah.
You want that one?
What do you want, maybe?
Yeah.
That. And that.
Nice.
So here they are, and they're salt and pepper, and they go.
Yeah.
A very special year for Foróige this year, celebrating its 60th birthday, and Sean Campbell, you're the man at the helm.
Absolutely. 60 years ago, Foróige was established in Muncoin in Tipperary. And it was formed by a group of visionaries who really wanted to see if non-formal education could be brought to Ireland in a meaningful way. We work with 57,000 young people right across the country in every county in a variety of ways, in clubs, youth cafes, projects. You know, and what you see today is one of our programs. It's an entrepreneurial program, teaching young people skills of business and getting them to actually form businesses. So it's a flagship for the organisation. It's a flagship for young people.
As part of your 60th birthday celebrations, you were honoured by President Higgins.
Yes, Foróige is founded, I suppose, on the hard work of over 5,000 volunteers who work week in, week out with young people right across communities across Ireland, urban and rural. And President Higgins was there to honour them and honour the work that they do with young people and honour just the commitment they have to our young people in Ireland. And it was great to have him.
Now, Sean, this trade fair is a lovely day out for the young people, but it's also the culmination of a lot of hard work.
Yes, this is a showcase for young people and young people's entrepreneurial spirit. Young people that have been involved in the NIFTE programme, one of the programmes run by Foróige. So they're here for the big award ceremony, the graduation ceremony for those who have done the programme, but also we will be announcing later on the Young Entrepreneur of the Year.
Well, we look forward to finding out who the winner is, and hopefully we'll have a chat with them before the end of the programme. Now, last year's winning entrepreneur was a woodcraftsman called Kyle McMahon. He was 18 at the time and involved with Foróige Bonnybrook Youth Reach. And Anne Casson recently went to visit him and have a chat in North Dublin.
Darndale, Dublin, this is your world, your home. What was it like growing up here?
What was it like? It was hard. It wasn't easy, like, you know, as I was getting older. The year was actually getting better and better, like, between the guards and the corporation, that they were cleaning the place up, so it wasn't too bad. And Darndale actually started turning into a nice place.
And when you were going to school and you were having trouble in school, what are your memories of that period of your life?
I don't even want to remember. They were horrible. I just really just hated school. You know, no time for school. Dreaded getting up in the morning. Hated it.
Nightmares. Phone calls, texts. Having to go down to the school all the time. You know, to sit in a room being told what he's done and what he's not done. And it was actually quite embarrassing. I think I sat there one day and cried in the room. And it was just a no-go with him, like, it's just, he was a hard child. That's the only way I can put it, like, I mean, out of the six, he was the hardest for me. Now, he always clung to me even as a baby, but, like, he had to be number one. He had to be number one.
Times I do airplanes, small cars, large, like medium large cars. There's jigsaws, there's personalised plaques, there's trophy plaques as well that can be done as well, and a lot of biography work, and in some cases mirror work as well. Feels great. Like, I love the smell of wood, especially if it's burning. It's very nice. But making toys in general, it's much better feeling, because I mean, you can buy plastic toys and stuff, and you can drop it once and it's broke. Wooden toys, they last forever, like, and I know that in my head, like, they're going to last a long while, and if they do break, you can always repair it.
Well, when Kyle arrived to us, he started in the Youth Reach Centre at 15, and I'll just say he was quite a challenging student, as a lot of our students can be, but there was something about him. I just recognised there was a little bit, good bit of potential there, and as I would always do with all my students, I'd ask them, you know, what interests them, what did they like, you know? So I said, in school, what did you like? And he said the only thing he liked was woodwork. And I said, okay, well, there's something that we could focus on. And he came up with the idea of Kyle's Woodcrafts, his business, and he just took it from there.
I love this little motor car, Kyle, a sort of old-fashioned racing car. And you have two types of wood here.
Yeah, this is actually the centre and the wheels is actually mahogany. It's very old mahogany there. And the other, the side panels there, it's piranha pine.
And how long would that have taken you to make?
Roughly, I'd say about 3 hours, max.
And do you varnish afterwards?
Yeah, well, the finishing now it'd take a day or two. But like I could be doing 10 cars at once in the finishing process. So that'd take 2 or 3 days to do.
And does it run smoothly?
You can test it out if you want. It is a prototype.
Well, your life changed, Kyle, when you discovered that you were going to become a father. Did that affect your thinking in terms of doing the program?
Yeah, well, it was like a kick in the backside. All right. Yeah, basically, she got pregnant and I realised that I'm gonna have to step up to the mark now. Like, you know, I can't be doing this things that I usually do. So when I came to the Youth Reach, I told them like the situation that I was in. And they basically just helped me along the way. Like, they told me as well that, right, you need to, it's not only you involved, like, you need to step up and all, get your act together and stuff like that. So, and then the Nifty program came up, so, and I thought it'd be a good opportunity to take part in that.
The before and after, and Kyle has been phenomenal. Just massive increase in his confidence, even his attendance in the centre, his application in all his other subjects as well. Like, all the other teachers will comment how much better, he's brighter, he's just a completely different guy. Like, he really is a massive success story for us.
And looking ahead to your future, your life with a purpose, what do you see for yourself?
Well, I'm hoping to obviously get an apprenticeship and get my level of skills now higher up. So, because there's a lot of stuff I really don't know, still don't know. So I need to be trained. And basically, I really want to just have my own business, just so I can provide for me and my family and just have a stable life.
Well, that's Kyle, and I have to say I'm dying to find out who will be getting the gong at this year's awards. Now, meanwhile, I am absolutely intrigued by the wonderful ideas and the business brains of these young people, still teenagers. A good example is Lauren McSharry. She's from Donegal, and she has taken weekend baking with her mom to a whole new level. Helen Marks reports on the rise and the rise of Lauren's home baking.
It's all go in the McSharry household in Killybegs as Lauren and her mum Karen weigh, mix and time to perfection their latest batch of baking.
Right, there is, 15, 16 minutes on those. Right, we'll do gingers now, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'll take that up to three.
There's a mouth-watering aroma in the kitchen, but it's a smell of success that pervades the family home, thanks to the previously untapped business acumen of this young girl and her business, Lauren's Home Baking.
But the first year of my business, I made about a few hundred euro just in the full year, but now it's grown up to tens of thousands. So it has grown a lot from the very start.
That start came through Foróige's Network for Teaching Entrepreneurship, or the NIFTY programme, which helps young people study aspects of starting and running a business. And it's run in schools and youth centres across the country.
One of our leaders from the shopping centre said, like, your mum is a chef, so why don't you do something around baking area? Initially it was just going down with a wee table, a garden table, with about 40 muffins, and now I'm going down with many different products and we have our own van.
What have we got today?
We have wholemeal bread, the plain soda bread.
Yeah.
We knew there was a niche in the market because there was no place in Killybegs which was selling home baking. Now 4.50 please. Thank you. For me on a Saturday it's a lot of produce, but then for mum and dad they're delivering three times a week to five different shops, and they have their market as well on a Friday in Fulcara, so it is a lot of produce, like they're baking 6-7 days a week. I know that I wouldn't have been able to do that with the business because I'm still in school and school is the main priority for me, like, so with them coming on board and growing the business a bit more, it really did help, like, because like my name is still on the business, so it's given me recognition as well, but it's also providing an income for them.
Karen, a chef, was made redundant when a local hotel closed down. She now works full-time for Lauren, while Liam, her dad, works part-time for her.
What about that rocky road you're on about?
Them.
Yeah, and what about that other one you really like? The
Malteser Squares?
Yeah.
Lauren has to have the last say on any decisions, any new things, any costing or anything like that. There always has to be, Lauren has to have the last say in it, which is fair enough because it is her business after all.
Because sometimes I was like, no, we could get more for this, or, and she's like, no, absolutely not. She will not do her customers. You know, she'll say, it's not Karen's home baking, it's Lauren's home baking. So
me and Mum get on really well, to be honest, like, we do have our days, like whenever I don't want to clean up or whatever, but like we do, we have to get on well when you're in a business together. We've invested in industrial ovens and we have two ovens in the house now, and we've decided that we need to put on an extension at the side of the house because it's gotten so big.
Just to remind us, this businesswoman is a 16-year-old in her transition year at St Catherine's in Killybegs. And along with her studies, she is a key player in the school's senior basketball team.
She is very wise, and every decision she'll make, she just goes from step to step, and that you must have better equipment to produce more to get bigger. And it's a great fearlessness now.
Without the NIFTY programme in the Foróige Centre, I wouldn't be here today. Like, they're still really supportive. They'll always ask how we're getting on, and I have been asked back to talk about my story and how I got on in the NIFTY programme. And like, I do be really nervous going up to do it. And people that came in and spoke to us about their NIFTY experience made me want to do better whenever I was doing it. So like, it is, it's really good. I love the way I'm able to help people get better in their business.
Having won the regional NIFTY competition back in 2010, Lauren's home baking made it to the nationals.
It was honestly one of the best experiences ever. Like, it was so nerve-wracking, but it was brilliant. We didn't win the national competition, but the year after I got asked back to do an alumni award, and that was basically for people who had kept their business up for the year, and I was so delighted that I did win it.
Some of them for me right there.
In the build-up to a market, even Lauren's little cousin Grace gets a job. Not to rest on her laurels though, Lauren looks to expanding her customer base, most recently into Letterkenny.
The more shops we can get into, the better, and every shop we're in, we're selling out every day nearly. I feel very much independent now, like I can go wherever I want without asking my dad for money. Like I was in Belgium last summer with my basketball team and I was able to pay for that myself, and without it I wouldn't have been going. Like I didn't know a young person could become an entrepreneur. It is amazing to think that young people like us can all come up with a good idea and make it work.
One of the nice things about being here is the opportunity to have a chat with some of the young people involved. And there is no doubt that young people face huge challenges in life. Sometimes they can be made a lot easier by the guidance of a mentor or maybe a role model. And there's nobody understands that better than the people who are involved in the Big Brother, Big Sister program, which is also run by Foróige. We're off to Blanchardstown now to find out more about that.
The Big Brother Big Sister programme is an internationally recognised youth mentoring programme that matches the young person who would benefit from some extra support up to a caring adult volunteer. They then meet up once a week for a couple of hours for an initial 1 year period, doing activities they both enjoy. The programme first came to Ireland in 2001 as a pilot programme in the West, and in 2006 Foróige began to roll out the programme nationwide, and we're in 14 counties at the moment. The core idea of the programme is that a caring and supportive friendship will develop between the young person and their big brother or big sister, and that this will reinforce the positive development of the young person.
My husband died, Aaron's dad, and I thought to have a male role model in his life would be great for his activities. He's so much into sports and outdoor activities, and his nan and granddad has a huge influence in his life, and his granddad like was great with him when he was younger, but now Aaron's activities are like so outgoing and that my dad's not able to do it with him anymore. I heard about the Big Brother Big Sister program through a friend of mine. Her daughter has a big sister and she explained about the program, so I looked into it and I thought it was great, so that's how I got Aaron involved. Noel really takes that role in and does everything, the more challenging the better.
My little brother is Aaron, and we've matched for about 9 months, and so we meet about once a week for 1 to 2 hours, and we just do different activities that we both enjoy.
The first time I met Noel was up in Foróige Youth Centre, and we were just paired up and put into a little room, and we were just talking about some of the activities we like to do together.
I suppose in advance we kind of spoke with the Big Brother programme about our interests and our hobbies, and we're matched on that basis, so I guess I kind of knew that we'd get along together. We've got similar hobbies, and you know, we just meet up weekly and, you know, have fun together. Well, we both love wildlife, as I say, so on our first activity we went to the zoo, to Dublin Zoo.
And we were just walking around looking at some of the penguins and the monkeys and giraffes and elephants.
It was just really an opportunity to get to know each other a little bit.
The programme is the development of a really positive relationship between the young person and their big brother or big sister volunteer.
So that'll always be very special to Aaron, like that. You'll never forget that.
Really, that day out was just to talk to each other, get to know maybe each other a bit better.
I kind of learn a lot from him too, because, you know, he's, you know, learns about this stuff in school, so I get as much from it as he does, really, I think, sometimes, you know.
The process of matching works by getting to know the young person and the volunteer through the intake process that we go through with all volunteers and all young people before they get accepted to the programme. So using this information then, we will match a young person to a volunteer with similar interests and compatible personalities, someone who we think that they'll get on really well with.
Nearly everything we have in common, like we play guitar together, and all the activities we like to do, we do it together.
We like to go running together, cycling.
Basketball, football, pool.
Very lucky to get Noel, I have to say. It was a brilliant match.
The programme is regarded as a success. We get really good feedback from the young people and the volunteers involved. It seems to be mutually beneficial.
I've seen a huge change in Aaron in the last 8 to 9 months. When I met him first, he was quite a shy, maybe introverted guy. And, you know, he has his own difficulties and challenges that he faces in life. But I suppose over the last number of months, I've really seen him open up. Like, and, you know, he enjoys our time together. We have a lot of fun. And I think he's learning more and more how to deal with the different challenges he faces, and it's great to see him develop and learn and you know, become a young man, really. You know, I see a very positive, bright future for Aaron.
I'm really looking forward to starting secondary school soon, so Noel's giving me all this good advice.
It's very positive think, from, I think, both, and bring out the best in each other.
It can be a great support to the young person, and the young person really benefits from it. We're always looking for new volunteers. We particularly at the moment have a demand for male volunteers, so we would encourage any males out there who think this is something that they could give back, it's a great chance to give back to their community, to get in touch with us.
The difference in him now is amazing. I can see a big change in him, and so can other people.
Back here at the Helix, it is make your mind up time for the judges. All of the young people are assembled in the Mahoney Hall here, awaiting the announcement of the winner of the 2012 Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award.
Step up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, now stop.
I'd like to announce and congratulate Connor from Sedan.
And here he is, manfully manning his stall, Connor Murray, this year's Young Entrepreneur of the Year. Congratulations, Connor.
Thanks very much.
What was it like, Connor, making your presentation this morning in really what amounts to a dragon's den?
It was very tough. You walked in, you set it up, and you hoped. You knew you were getting six good businesses, so you hoped. You had to make the pitch absolutely perfect. And six big hitters in the commercial world straight in front of you. And even Bobby Kerr, one of the actual dragons, like, at the start, I was trembling. Like, I couldn't get into it, but I felt the same with all the presentations, even to get here. It's easy to understand, but yet fiendishly difficult. Daunting experience, but you got through it, and I'm all the better for it, I suppose.
Connor, the object of the exercise is to have one pin left on the board.
Exactly,
and how do you go about that?
So you set it up with one of the corners free. So the colours doesn't matter in the setup. So you get one tee and you jump it over another. You're only allowed to jump it one space.
Okay.
Into an empty space, and you take out the one you've jumped over. So like that, and you keep it going until you have one left on the board.
And does it get difficult?
It gets very difficult.
How?
The first three moves, I suppose my cousin actually,
he run out of space.
My cousin, I gave it to him, and he does maths. He does computers in college. He said, oh, it looks very easy. How many possibilities can there be? And I gave it to him, and he tried it, and he couldn't get it. He went home, wrote a computer program. There's only six ways to get it right, and I think there's a couple of thousand to get it wrong. So
Wow. Apparently
there is a lot of ways to get it wrong. So
where did you get the idea?
It's a traditional wooden game. When I was on holidays in America, I saw it in a restaurant. It was just on the table. It was there to keep you occupied when you're waiting for your food. And we did it, and we were out there having a family meal. We were trying it out. It was great fun. And I looked at it and I thought, oh, that's a great game. It just triggered something in my head, and I thought, make some prototypes, give them to my friends, see what happens. And from there, it just got bigger and bigger. So.
Cogordachas arís le Conor, and congratulations also to all of the young people who took part in that stimulating entrepreneurial programme. And of course, happy 60th birthday to Foróige, a wonderful organisation that has the welfare of Irish young people at its core. Well, I hope you've enjoyed our visit to the Helix. Ona hainear a bhuireann, I oahagur. On Wednesday's Nationwide, first-time author Kathleen McMahon, her inspiration and her lucrative book deal. An ex-priest, husband, father of children, author and campaigner. And celebrations of the famous Mardike in Cork City.